I recently flashed my Eachine E011 with that alternative firmware I mentioned in my review, the main feature of which is that it allows you to access an Acro mode, and just thought I'd interrupt the regularly scheduled programming with a short video on how I went about this. Before we get started, I want to mention that this mod do require some soldering experience and computer know-how. Study the links in the description to make sure you know what you're getting yourself into beforehand, as you could easily mess up your quadcopter otherwise. Beyond the quadcopter itself, a soldering iron and basic tools, you'll also need an ST-Link version 2 USB programmer, which can be bought online for cheap. With that out of the way, let's get started. The first step is to gain access to the pads on the board used to connect it to your computer. They're located on the bottom side of the board, so remove the screws and unplug the motors. Be careful when unplugging the motors, I nearly tore one of the connectors off the board. To be able to connect the programmer to the board, you need to solder on some pins. I simply cut a couple off from an unused header. The actual soldering is a little tricky. I found the easiest way was to apply some solder to the pad, hold the pin in place with a pair of tweezers, and reheat the solder. I did all four pads, but you're only going to need the ones marked GND, DAT, and CLK. As other guides will tell you, there is also an alternative set of connection points you can use. It's time to prepare the software side of things. You need to install an application called ST-Link Utility, which also provides the drivers for the programmer. If you intend to compile the source code yourself, you also need to install the development environment Keil. Both are a real hassle to download. Of course, you also need to download the alternative firmware itself. It's located on GitHub, which is a source code repository. Select Clone or Download, download zip, and then extract the contents of the archive to any location on your computer. You're now ready to flash the firmware. Connect your ST-Link version 2 programmer to the board according to this illustration. Connect the programmer to your computer, and finally connect the board to the battery. If the diagram looks a little backwards, it's because the pads on the board are apparently mislabeled. The board comes read-write protected, so the first thing you need to do is unlock it, which will also erase the original factory firmware. Don't worry though, a copy of it comes packaged with the alternative firmware distribution. Open ST-Link Utility and connect to the board. There will be an error message saying that it cannot read the memory, which is expected. Select Target, Option Bytes, change Readout Protection to level 0, and click Apply. Close the ST-Link Utility and unplug the battery from the board. When it comes down to actually flashing the alternative firmware, you have two options. The simpler but less flexible one is to flash a pre-compiled firmware using the Program menu item under Target in the ST-Link utility. I didn't go this route, so I can't demonstrate the process. The slightly more advanced option is to compile the source code from scratch and upload it to the board using the Keil development environment. The advantage of this is that you'll be able to customize the firmware according to your preferences before you flash it. If you choose the latter option, double-click the Keil project file in the Silverware folder of the firmware distribution. Keil should start and may ask you to download and update some of its components. Once it's finished, make your changes to the configuration of the firmware found in the config.h file and then select Project Build Target to compile the source code. As long as you don't receive any errors or warnings, connect the board to the battery and select Flash, then Download. You should see a progress bar, after which, unless you're told otherwise, the flash has completed successfully. That's it! Now simply put everything back together again. If you made the pins short enough, you won't have to desolder them, which is good in case you want to flash the quadcopter again later. By default, your flash E011 will start up in level mode, although this can be changed in the source code. To switch to Acro mode, perform the gesture left left down with the right stick if in mode 2. The quadcopter will confirm by blinking its LEDs. To switch back, enter right right down. Thank you for watching. I also want to thank user Silver13 for his Silverware firmware and everyone contributing to the community surrounding it.